Tuesday, April 10th,
we have some more of our Murph Prep. So we have two sets of five chin-ups with a 6-second lower. We'll rest 1 minute between those sets. Then we have max regular pull-ups with a 5-second lower. Then we'll rest 1 minute, and then we'll do a max chin-up hold. So if we come back to the top here to talk about our chin-ups, that is a underhand grip with the 6-second lower. If you need to use a band there, you can, but use a band that will allow you to keep these reps, but not so easy when you're sitting there repping them out. If you are decent at chin-ups, but you've kind of get to maybe 3 and you're starting to hit failure, you can kip your way to the top to maintain your 6-second lower from there. Then we go to our max regular pull-ups with our 5-second lower. So ideally we're looking at around 10 here. So same concept applies there. If you're getting into those bigger numbers and you're having to kip your way up, you probably just want to come down from there. Then we have our max chin-up hold. It doesn't matter how you get to the top. You just have to get to the top. You're just going to hold with your chin not resting on the bar. Keep it above. And that'll be a max set there. We're looking for at least 20 seconds or higher. Then we're going to move on to our 7-minute AMRAP. So that's as many rounds as possible of max push presses. So that is 95 for the guys, 65 for the ladies. The kicker here is every time you drop the bar, it is a 15 air squats there. So also on the max push press, we don't want you guys to game it and kind of hold it for 10 seconds at the top or hold it for 10 seconds here. We don't want to see more than a 5-second hold at the top or a 5-second hold at the bottom. If you're having to hold that long, you just need to go ahead and drop it. Obviously, you don't want to rush through these air squats, kind of nice, easy air squats, and then pick the bar up and get a bigger set in there. All right, guys, hope it's fun.